Dan Henry and I'm back with another video. Let's talk about the side of real estate that is not the most glamorous, but still a very real and necessary part of our job, okay? And that is stubborn clients. Ooh, 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 ooh. I've had a couple clients come for me a couple times. Stubborn, difficult, whatever name you want to give them. We have to know how to navigate that and still work with these people so that we can successfully close transactions and make sure that they're happy and we're happy. Now, how do we do that? I wanna talk about all the ways that I set expectations on the front end to minimize those frustrating things that may happen on either side and when to just let go, okay? Because all money ain't good money and it's not worth your health, insanity, and mental peace. So woosah. And let's get into it. So one of the very first things that I do when I have a person come to me and say that they either want to sell their house or have me help them buy a house is I do a consultation. And in that consultation, I just basically tell them how I show houses, how quickly I follow up, how often I check messages, what my personal business hours are. If you text me at 11 p.m., I'm not going to respond, okay? I'll see it, but I'm not going to respond, okay? That's number one. How many houses am I gonna show you in one sitting? Are we gonna list your house at the price point that I think we should, or are we gonna list it at your price point, which is significantly higher? If we do list it significantly higher, are you going to listen when I say it's time to do a price decrease? Do we have an agreement on what that's gonna look like? So a number of these conversations need to be had on the front end so that when that comes up, it's not a surprise to either person in the way that you choose to handle that conversation. Another thing that I can almost guarantee you'll run into is when you are selling a house. Oftentimes it's maybe a first-time home buyer and either mom or dad are coming or a sibling is coming or whatever the case may be. And all of the non-decision makers tend to have the most to say, right? So on the front end, I'll tell people, you know, we're limited to a certain amount of people that we can bring in the house. Mom and dad are more than welcome to come, but I just want to make sure that when it comes to making decisions, that you're still leaning on my professional advice and opinion. Because one thing that parents like to do, they like to nitpick on a house. I like to make sure that I'm talking to the parents and saying, well, mom, well, dad, what did your first house look like? Mm-hmm. And how many years ago was that? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is not that. This is not that, yeah. Oh, how much was the one that you saw on Zillow? Yeah, that Zestimate is completely wrong. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the only way that you're gonna get a true and accurate representation of the price of a house is if a skilled and licensed real estate agent runs a comparative market analysis on that property. Have I ran one yet? No, I haven't. But I will, I'll be more than happy to run one if we're gonna end up submitting an offer on this property. Because who has the real estate license? Me. And obviously that's an exaggeration. I'm not gonna be that sarcastic and sassy to somebody's parents. Cause people, you know, you're not gonna talk to my mama any kind of way, right? Find a tactful way to say those things and still assert yourself as the professional in the situation, but don't let the parents just run all over everything because it's gonna go left very, very quickly. Like you will have a number of deals die because the non-decision makers are trying to make decisions. So setting those expectations on the front end is really, really, really gonna help you to cut down on the amount of clients who get frustrated with you, who are stubborn, they don't wanna listen, they're hard-headed, whatever the case may be. Another really, really important thing is to just be honest. Be honest the whole entire time. Be brutally honest, okay? Tell people that that house is probably not the best investment, but you will support them if they want to walk through and buy that one. Or, you know, tell them that the comps don't support the list price on that house and you can submit an offer but you think it should be lower. Or don't just tell them what they want to hear because it'll come back and bite you for certain. And then they're gonna ask, well, like, how come you didn't tell me? Or that's not what you said before. Or whatever the case may be. You never wanna just pacify your clients. You wanna be honest with them throughout the whole transaction and they're gonna thank you for it in the end. You'll be in moments where you're getting asked questions that you may not have the answer to, or you feel uncomfortable, or you wanna say something to make someone feel better in the moment, but you know that that's not a whole truth. It may be a half truth or something like that. And it's not that big of a deal to make them feel better. Never, ever, ever, ever do that. Always be upfront and honest the entire time. If you being honest is not what they wanna hear, sometimes they'll wanna fire you. Sometimes they'll wanna go with the agent who said that they'll sell their house for $100,000 more. Or they'll wanna go with the realtor who said they'll show them 7 houses in one day, or whatever the thing may be. Let them go, okay? It's not worth your sanity and your well-being. And I'm saying this from experience as well. When I first got licensed, I had the worst client. It was so bad. They almost got me out of real estate. Every day I would wake up, because this was the only client I had at the time as well, because I was brand new license. This was my first client. So I pulled out all the stops. I was showing them houses almost every day. We were seeing like 4, 5, 6 houses at a time. And they were across all these different cities. So it was like a 20-minute drive to this house and a 30-minute drive to this one and 15. I was just doing all I could to try to get this little commission check. And it was like, I think their pre-approval was $175,000 or something like that. But they had this champagne taste with this Kool-Aid budget. So every time I would show them a house in their price range, they were just like, oh, well, this isn't really up to our standards, or I can't believe you would bring us out to see this kind of house. And it's just like, this is what you can afford. What do you mean? What are you saying? So it got to the point where I hated just the idea of even pulling up to a house and they were there. I was like, I cannot do this. I can't do this anymore. I would go home and just cry, because they would speak to me in ways that made me feel like I wasn't a good agent, or I wasn't working hard to find listings that fit their search criteria, or whatever the case may be. And finally, I called them up and I was like, hey, our contract expires next week. I'm choosing not to renew it. Best wishes to you and your husband. And I let them go. And it was an immediate weight lifted off of my shoulders, because I made the decision for me. Granted, I didn't know where my next dollar was gonna come from, but I didn't even care anymore. I said, it is fine. There is more fish in the sea, okay? There's plenty of houses out here and plenty of people that wanna buy them. So I'm not even gonna trip. And ever since then, I've always chosen me first. Always, always, always choose yourself, because this is a very, very hard job. Real estate is not easy by any means, despite what HGTV might make you think, or Selling Sunset, or any of the other shows that we see on TV of how easy it is to be a real estate agent and sell a house. It's not. It's emotionally exhausting. It is physically taxing. It is incredibly tiresome. You're challenged in every way, physically, emotionally, financially. It's a lot. And if you don't create boundaries for yourself, not only with your stubborn or difficult clients, but the ones that are just overly needy, you're gonna get burnt out. You're gonna get burnt out very, very quickly. So I highly suggest that you put these tips and tricks in place to make sure that when you are fully, fully up and running in the real estate business and you've got a ton of clients, you've got buyers and sellers and everything in between, everybody knows what to expect from you. They know what you are expecting from them. And it's this beautiful mutual symbiotic relationship that ends in a commission check. So what are some ways that you guys have been working with clients and your buyers? I wanna hear your horror stories. Put them in the comments. Do you have any like crazy stories of like working with a stubborn buyer? Did you make it to the closing table, or did you end up firing them, or did they fire you? Let me know in the comments below. And in the meantime, in between time, always remember that you, yes, you are pure gold, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.